You know, there's a lot of women on farms, but mostly they don't get the recognition. You know, they're just the farmer's wife and she does all the milking and rears the calves kind of thing.
Farmer isn't a gender term. It is something that we've habitually associated with men.
It was a very, very male-dominated industry for a long time. We're starting to see definitely a changing of the guard coming through. Women are on par, and if not better in a lot of cases, to the guys.
It's a 5,000 acre property that we're operating on here. My name's Beck Middleton and I'm a dairy share farmer and manager on a dairy in South Australia. I am the farmer, I'm the manager here. My partner very hurriedly attests to that. So he's the farmhand and I'm the farm manager, but yes, sometimes that's a little challenging for some people to accept. I've been in the industry now for 13 years and I could count the number of female managers I've met on one hand. We do have to prove ourselves. A lot of it comes down to, I think, perception of physical ability. That, you know, are you strong enough to roll a cow? I've had questions very recently of people asking me if I know how to drive a tractor, and it just makes you sort of step back and go, wow, really? You wouldn't ask a man that same question. You know, there's a lot of women milking cows and driving tractors, feeding calves. A lot of women, even if they're not out doing that stuff behind the scenes, running the books, that's a very common arrangement.
In fact, 49% of on-farm income in Australia is generated by women.
We're half of the, you know, decision makers, so I think people coming in from outside and contractors and banks and the like, they need to really be taking women a lot more seriously.
Even though women make up around one third of the Australian agricultural workforce, it wasn't until recent decades that their presence within the industry was even acknowledged. In Australia, women weren't legally recognised as farmers until 1994.
Up until that point, they were seen as the sleeping partner or the silent partner. If you go to Google Images and put in the search term farmer, you will come back with images 9 out of 10 showing white middle-aged men. The problem with that is that across the world, 50% of farmers are women. So where are the women?
Lisa has been a curator at Museums Victoria for 30 years. Through her project, The Invisible Farmers, she's rewriting Australia's agricultural history books to include women.
And when I started working in this sphere, I looked around this vast collection of agriculture and I could not find the women's stories. Women have always been farming, but our idea of what farming involves keeps changing. They're the nurse, they're the strategic advisor, they're the accountant, raising children, feeding everyone in that family, and that helps support and sustain that family farm. Often we dismiss that as irrelevant, that therefore you can't call those women farmers. A really important part of the project is to encourage female farmers to share their stories. We can't inspire young women to enter the field of agriculture unless we've got role models, unless they go into Google and find women who are identifying themselves as farmers.
I think women have been reluctant to label themselves as farmers, but these days women can step up, they can be loud and proud.
Fiona Simpson knows too well about the gender divide within the agriculture industry.
I certainly think as the first woman to hold the role of the President of National Farmers Federation, there were some eyebrows raised. Australian agriculture is known to lead the way in lots of things, but we don't want to be known for not having enough women in our roles. We don't want to be known at being really bad at doing diversity. And at the moment, that's where we are currently at.
When it comes to the business end of agriculture, they have some of the least gender diverse boardrooms in the country, with roughly 2% of CEOs in the agriculture industry being women. And when it comes to leadership roles, that number is also well below the national average.
It tells me that there is still a fairly blokey culture in most of the agribusiness boardrooms and representative boardrooms across Australia. It's going to take a determined effort over a number of years and at a number of levels to actually change that culture.
So to kickstart that change, National Farmers have introduced a program to encourage women through the ranks.
It's the first program of its kind, focuses on mentoring would-be leaders with people who are already making a difference in their fields. There are an amazing array of skills in women and amongst women out on the land, and it would be a shame for our industry if we weren't to harness them in some ways.
But whilst the results of this program are yet to be seen, gender quotas are off the table.
When we start out, we want to be inclusive, we don't want to be divisive, and quotas is going to be very divisive. quotas might be something we want to embrace in the future, but at the moment we need to actually start the journey and start creating meaningful change.
Whilst most men attest to the skills that women bring to the land, Fiona says it's those men who need to step up and champion the change.
8:30, 8:40.
I definitely champion the case for women through agriculture. We're seeing more and more of them come through, whether it be on agronomy, whether it be on the livestock side. They're being shown as a very, very important part of the industry and our future.
If I ever have a daughter, I definitely want them to have the opportunity to have a go in agriculture. I'd definitely be the first bloke to stand up and support females, definitely.
We certainly need them to be recognised, and it's got to be up to the wider community to appreciate what women do on the land.
As I was saying, as the younger blokes come through the system, I think women will come with it.
If we don't actually address this, there's going to be a vast untapped pool of knowledge and information and ideas out there that just isn't being recognised. I think it's a waste of potential that, you know, people might be put off and then you've lost them.
You know, we need more females in this industry, and it, you know, if we want it to keep going and be successful, yeah, I think we need to head the right way.
We all depend on farmers. They provide us with all the things that we just take for granted. And women are half of what it is that makes our agriculture happen.
A lot of the older blokes are set in their ways and they will move on. And I think there's a different mentality coming. And with that, I think you'll find that more and more women will become more focused in the workforce.